Hey everyone, this is Eric from Datafeedr.com. In this video, I want to take you through the process of identifying and connecting with the affiliate networks and merchants who sell the products which you want to promote on your website. So like I said, my website is about rock climbing gear. I want to sell rock climbing harnesses, shoes, helmets, etc. So how do I know which merchants sell these products? You may already be familiar with a couple of merchants that sell the products you're interested in promoting, but how can you discover more merchants? Well, let's hop on over to the Datafeedr Scratchpad. You can go to scratchpad.datafeedr.com. Here, you can search our entire database of products, nearly 1 billion products, and find the merchants and networks that are promoting or selling the products that you want to promote on your website. So, like I said, I'm interested in promoting rock climbing shoes, harnesses, helmets, etc. So let's do a search for rock climbing shoes and see which affiliate networks and merchants are selling those products. I'm going to start with the basic search here in the any field. I want to put that in quotes just to restrict my results a little bit. So I'm rock climbing, and in the name field, I want that the word to be. I want the word shoe to appear, and I want the word men's to appear. We'll do one for women's when we start building the website. And I'm only interested in promoting products to the U.S. market, so I'm going to set my currency to USD so I don't get European products that aren't going to be that my audience isn't going to be interested in. So we've entered three different fields, so let's just start with a search there and see what that gets us. Okay, you can start to see some rock climbing shoes have started to show up in our results, but we're getting a few unrelated results. So I'm going to take a couple of steps to further refine this search so that we have a more precise search result. As you can see, we have 3,400 products. So the first thing I'm going to do is I know that I'm not going to be selling rock climbing shoes that are less than $75. So I'm going to set the final price, needs to be greater than or equal to $75. And from there, I'll click search again. That'll eliminate a lot of accessories and things that we're not interested in. All right, so let's take a look. So now we're down to 774 products. This looks a lot better. Now, let's take a look at who are all of the affiliate networks that are working with these merchants. So we click the affiliate networks icon here. We can see there's 9. And we're getting products from AvantLink, Impact, FlexOffers, Commission Junction, ShareASale, etc. So these are all affiliate networks. And now let's take a look at the merchants who are selling those 774 products. These are the 26 merchants who are selling those 774 products. OMC Gear has the majority of them, 314. And then we go down to backcountry.com from FlexOffers, backcountry.com from Impact, Competitive Cyclist, Gear Coop, Walmart, Arc'teryx, Moose Jaw, etc. So I want to pop back to the Networks tab. And I already have an account at AvantLink. But if you don't already have an account at one of these networks, you can just click the link. That'll take you to the affiliate network website. And from there, you can click Apply Now. And then in this case, you would sign up as a publisher or an affiliate. You're not the advertiser or merchant. So in this case, I'd click Publisher Affiliate, and I'd go through the sign-up process. Same goes for these others. So if I didn't already have an account at Commission Junction, I'd click that link. Go over to Commission Junction and click Sign Up. And then I'm going to sign up as a publisher, not the advertiser. So under Publishers, I'll click Sign Up. And let's do one more on ShareASale. If I didn't already have an account at ShareASale, I would click that link. I would click Sign Up. And in this case, I'm signing up as an affiliate, not the merchant and not an agent. So an affiliate. And from there, I'd go through the process of creating a ShareASale account. Now, I already have an AvantLink Commission Junction and ShareSale account. I don't have accounts for these other few affiliate networks. So I just want to display products from those three networks that I already have an account with. So as you can see here, we have the network ID. For AvantLink, it's 126. For Commission Junction, it's 3. And for ShareSale, it's 6. So what I can do is I can come over here to this network IDs field and type in those three numbers separated by a comma. 126 for AvantLink, 3 for Commission Junction, and 6 for ShareSale. Now, when I run my search, I'm only going to get products from merchants supported by those three networks. All right, so here's the networks pane. We can see that we only return products from AvantLink, Commission Junction, and ShareSale. Let's go take a look at the products. Now we're down to 442. All right, so those are all looking fantastic. Now, the important thing here is to see which merchants are supporting those 442 products. So we'll take a look at our merchants. No surprise, OMC still giving us the most because they're from AvantLink. GearCoop, Arc'teryx from Commission Junction, Eastern Mountain Sports from ShareSale, and so on. So now we've identified the merchants who sell the products we're interested in promoting on our website. So the next thing you'll want to do is you'll want to actually, if you're interested in promoting OMC gear products on your website, you'll go to AvantLink, log in, and apply to the OMC gear merchant program. Same for GearCoop. If you want to display GearCoop products on your website, you would log in at AvantLink and apply to the GearCoop merchant program. Same for Arc'teryx. If you're interested in promoting their products, you would log in at Commission Junction and apply to the Arc'teryx merchant program. You do need to get approved by each merchant that you want to display products from. But this ensures that you receive 100% of the commissions that you're referring to those merchants. So now that you've identified the merchants you want to work with, and after you've applied and been approved by those merchants, the next step is to connect those merchants with your Datafeedr website and start building out your affiliate store. I'll see you in the next video.